Welcome everybody to another video, and in advance, sorry for any background noise. The wind here is so strong, you can literally hear it through literally the whole house. But today I'm going to be going through a walkthrough, not really a tutorial, I'm just going to be doing it and you can follow along with anything else. Making this cool Saquon Barkley photo. It could literally be any athlete you want, but I chose Saquon. But it's not gonna be a full tutorial, but I'm just gonna be walking through it with you guys. And today's program I'm using is called Affinity Photo, so let's get into it. Okay, so what I do first is I put my photo of Saquon in. And what we want to do is scale that down a bit. Probably takes up about that much space. Okay, then what we want to do is resasterize or whatever you want to say. Okay, now I'm going to use my magic, selection brush, and just get the outline of him. Subtract a bit here. Let's add a little bit back. There we go. And then we want to subtract this area because we don't want this in. And then we want to add some of his jersey back in. The colors are too close, it's picking up the background. Okay, that should be good. So now, hold on. Now what we want to do is go to our refine, black matte, and then we just want to smooth it a bit. That looks pretty good. We're going to apply, and then we're going to duplicate that. Oh, why isn't it not working? Okay, we need to click on the layer it's on, and then duplicate it. Oh, I didn't reset. Okay, this is a complete mess. Okay, we need to resaturize it. And now we can, there we go. Duplicate it, and now that's what we got. So I'm just gonna put a background behind him real quick so I can see what parts. I use pink a lot so you can really tell like the difference. Like you can obviously tell if her stuff's sticking out. That was a pretty good selection. There's a little bit right here I'm gonna erase. Let me turn down the opacity a bit, and then we can just get rid of that. Yep, that's good. Okay, now that we got that, we can delete this. Now we're gonna hide that layer for a bit, and then I have another picture of Saquon. What to do with this? What did I do here? I made it the back, yeah. Okay, so we're gonna, because I want you to be able to see his face just a little bit. Okay, so maybe right there, vaporize it off of it. That's good enough. So now that we got this, I'm gonna add an adjustment layer and make it HSL and turn the saturation down all the way. And then we're just gonna keep it like that. Now what we're gonna do is, actually we're not gonna really do anything right now. Hold on, so we're gonna use the pen tool. We're just gonna make some lines so we can put certain stuff in. So with this, we're gonna fill red. Then we're gonna make that blend mode to darken. Then here, I don't wanna make it a certain pattern because I don't want it to be any pattern. We're gonna move this one over a bit. And we're gonna add another one right here. Now I'm gonna fill this one with a darkish blue. That's not darkish blue. That is not blue at all. What happens if I click darken? Yeah, that's not blue. We need to redo that. Oh, I think I was in, let's see. Yeah, I had it under the adjustment. Okay, there we go. Now we're going to change it to darken. I'm just going to move this adjustment layer onto this picture, so now I won't have to worry about that happening again. So now we got the background. We're just going to do this again until we got the whole background covered up. I'll fill that in red and then darken. Let me see how the lines are. That's pretty good. And I think we're gonna do one more blue and then one more red. So this blue one can be like really skinny. I'm gonna fill that in dark blue. Darken. And then the rest can be red. Darken. Okay. So it's nothing yet, but kinda already looks cool. But yeah. And now we're just gonna place Saquon there and put him above all of them. Okay. Oh my god, that wind's so strong. What we're gonna do is click on Saquon, go up to filters, go to sharpen, clarity, and put that all the way up. And you can tell when I go put it down and up, you can tell like what's changing. Like, it's getting a little darker when you put it up. You can see more the wrinkles in his jersey. You can see more texture. When it's down, it just looks flatter. And we're gonna put it like that. Now what we're gonna do is right click on Saquon, go to layer effects, and for outer shadow, make sure it's black, and then turn the radius up a bit. Oh wait, no, because you can't really tell yet. Okay. What I want to do is grab my paintbrush tool. Nope, that's not what I want. I'm going to go to textured brushes and I'm going to click on my paintbrush tool. This can be any color you want. What color do I have? Black right now. I want white. Go back to brushes. Now, is this a good one? I think this one would be a better one. I think this is the one I used in my other one. Maybe a little bit of the other one to get like a difference. We're gonna put them on top of that and see how it looks. That looks pretty good. And now that's really all we had to do with the paintbrush layer. Now that we got this, we're going to go to, we're actually gonna duplicate them because I wanna try to do something. I duplicate them. And then we're gonna hide the top two. So for the bottom one, we're gonna go layer effects, cover color overlay. And then we're gonna do like this blue. Yeah. And then we're gonna do, for the next one, we're gonna do red. Color overlay, and we want a lighter red. Not like red, but like that color, that looks pretty cool. And then we're gonna put this one back. And now we're just gonna move them away so it kind of looks cool. We're gonna move this one right there. And I think that looks pretty good. And now what we're gonna do is add our shadows. So I'm gonna right click on him, go to outer shadow. We're gonna increase the radius a bit and then make the intensity a little bit more. And this kind of gives it like more texture, especially the inner shadow. So we're gonna increase the radius and then intensity, we're gonna improve that a little bit. That looks pretty good. I'm gonna see if there's any other adjustment we could do. Let me go to HSL. We're gonna make sure it's only on him. And I wanna see. I'm gonna rise the saturation a bit so you can see more of the color. Make it a little bit bright. That's not bright, that's darker. Let's put it at 1. Yeah, that's good. No, that's pretty cool. Oops, didn't mean to do that. Let me lock this in place. Now we're pretty much done. What else did I do here? Oh yeah, the text. So for the text, I'm gonna do like the same thing I did with him. What font did I use? I use Road Rage. So yeah, I'm gonna use this font called Road Rage. I'm gonna make it white. And then I'm gonna duplicate that and just bring it down here. I'm gonna change that to Barkley. Now I wanna line it up, but I want it behind him. Not behind his shadows, just be like behind the color, but just behind him. So we're gonna duplicate that 2 times. So now there's 3. And like with the Sake one, we're gonna do just change the color. So no. I want that color. Then for this one, I want that color. No. Want that color. And then we can just move the text around a bit. Can I change that to Barkley? Gonna move it in front of him so you can see the whole text, and then just like the other, we're gonna duplicate that 2 times and then change the color. So this one's gonna be blue, This one's going to be red-ish. And then this one's just gonna be white. And now time to move them around. Move that down. And then move that one up. And if I had access to internet right now, I'd put like the Giants logo down here or something. But I don't, so yeah. This is a pretty cool design. I think it's good. And yeah, that's it. Anyways, guys, if you enjoyed this video, please leave a like, subscribe, turn on notifications, all that. Anyways, I'm out, guys. Peace.